It's time for Real Talk with Brian and Dan, the weekly talk radio show dedicated to discussing important real estate topics, plus insight into the local community. With a combined experience of over 50 years as local real estate brokers from the Eastside Real Estate Team at Keller Williams Realty Bellevue. Here's your hosts, Brian Levitt and Dan Edwards.
Well, good afternoon. Welcome to Real Talk with Brian and Dan on 1150 KKNW, the first show of 2020.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, Brian. It is Wednesday, January 8th, and we are glad that you are joining us this afternoon. In addition to listening on the radio, we are also live on YouTube, streaming live at 1150 KKNW. If you Google that, you'll find us. And also, if you want to listen to past episodes, you can find them anywhere podcasts are syndicated, also known as Google Podcast, Apple Podcast, and others. And lastly, but not least, is you can find videos of each broadcast on our website at theeastsiderealestateteam.com or our YouTube channel at the Eastside Real Estate Team. And we have another great show starting off 2020 with fantastic guests. We have Melissa Reeves of Story Fruition. And back with us again is Rob Young of Oasis Senior Advisors. But as usual, before we get to those guests, it's time for some Real Talk. Today's Real Talk segment, we're going to talk about the 2020 real estate projections that may surprise you and the expert insights of 2020 in the housing market.
This will be an interesting year for residential real estate with a presidential re-election, re-election.
Whoa.
Freudian slip maybe, I don't know. Election taking place this fall and talk of a possible recession, the R word, occurring before the end of the year. Predicting what will happen in the 2020 U.S. housing market can be a challenge. You see, nobody's got a crystal ball.
No.
But there are clues.
Yep.
So as a result, taking a look at the combined projections from the most trusted entities in the industry when it comes to mortgage rates, home sales, and home prices, those insights are incredibly valuable, and they may surprise you.
Yeah, so we're going to have our mortgage moment a little later, but mortgage projections from the National Association of Realtors, Mortgage Bankers Association, Fannie Mae, and Freddie Mac, all of these mortgage groups, they're going to forecast rates that they're going to remain stable through 2020. Now, rates have remained under 5% for the last decade. So the 20s actually recorded on average below 5. And here are some of the other past decades. So the 70s, I was a wee lad in the 70s. So it was 8.86. And the 80s, ooh, Brian remembers these.
Oh, yeah.
Gosh, 12.70%. Ooh, man.
These are averages, right?
Yes, average for the decade.
Because it was 13.5 when I started.
It went up to 13. How high? It went higher than that.
Yeah, it did.
Right?
But when I started my real estate career, 13.5%. And we still sold homes.
Still sold
believe
homes.
Or not.
All right, believe it or not. 1990s was 8.12. And the 2000s, so 2000 to 2010, was 6.29. So essentially, the 2010s. The last decade we just saw the lowest interest rates.
We're lower now and projected to stay there.
Yep.
So home prices. Here are the projections of home appreciation from six different expert entities that look closely at home values. CoreLogic, 5.4%. Fannie Mae, 4.1%. Z Report, 3.9%. National Association of Realtors, 3.6%. Freddie Mac, 3.2%. Mortgage Bankers Association, 3.1. Each group has home values continuing to improve through 2020, with four of them seeing price appreciation increase at a greater pace than it did in 2019, which was 3.5%.
Wow.
I think we'll be in that 3.5 looking at this.
Yeah, and these are nationwide numbers, so you know, some places faster than others, but that's a conservative approach.
Yeah,
and I prefer to tell clients that they can expect 3.5% over the next year.
And
so what were you going to say?
I was going to say that's one of the greatest aspects of home ownership is that appreciation isn't on your investment. It's on the entire value of the asset.
Right.
So you
your
put your down payment down.
Yep.
You don't get 3.5% of your down. You get 3.5% of
the entire
value
asset.
Of the asset. So
leverage,
that's huge.
Baby.
It's leverage. Yep.
So is recession possible? In early 2019, a large percentage of economists began predicting recession may occur in 2020. In addition, a recent survey of potential home purchases showed that over 50% agreed it would occur this year. The economy, however, remains strong in the fourth quarter and has caused many to rethink that possibility. So Goldman Sachs, in their 2020 outlook, said markets sounded the recession alarm this year. That's this year. Forecaster now sees a 33% chance of recession over the next year. In contrast, the recession model actually suggests only a 20% probability. So despite the record age of our expansion and the late cycle problems, inflationary overheating, financial imbalances, stuff I don't know much about, but they're just saying it doesn't look as threatening as it, as they had forecasted for 2019.
What experts are saying is we'll likely see in 2020, or what we'll likely see in 2020, Danielle Hale, chief economist at Realtor.com, says, quote, "I think the biggest surprise from the forecast is how long the market is staying in this low inventory environment, especially as millennials are in a major home buying phase. Sellers will contend with flattening price growth and slowing activity, with existing home sales down 1.8%. Nationwide, you can look to flat home prices with an increase of less than 1%. So it contradicts a little bit some of the other stuff. And my gut and experience is that with our inventory so very low, supply and demand will push prices up.
Yeah, it's important for the listener to understand that these pundits, these economists are nationwide economists. When we discussed with Pat Stone, we talked about the microcosm of the Northwest. It's a little different. So Mike Frentanoni, chief economist of the Mortgage Bankers Association, says interest rates will, on average, remain lower. These lower rates will, in turn, support both purchase and refinance volume in 2020. Skylar Olson, director of economic research at Zillow, says if the current trend holds, then slower means healthier and smaller means affordable. Yeah, they expect a slower market than we've become accustomed to in the last few years. Consumers will continue to absorb available inventory, and the market will remain competitive in much of the country. And we know, because we talked about these numbers at the end of December, that our inventory is down. So I don't think slower is what we're looking for in the Northwest.
Right. Well, slower is relative, because here, you know, I've had listings where I've had 20 plus offers the first weekend. You know, so slower means one or two.
Yeah.
You know,
still going to be selling.
Still selling, right. Bottom line, mortgage rates are projected to remain under 4%, causing sales to increase in 2020. With growing demand and a limited supply of inventory, prices will continue to appreciate. While the threat of an impending recession seems to be softening, it looks like 2020 may be a solid year for the real estate market.
Yeah, I agree. I think my main takeaway for this is buyers need to make sure they're really fully qualified. And it's a step back from the last 2 years. The last 2 years, it was like, oh, we can take our time.
Nope,
I think you should be serious. All right. Well, that concludes our Real Talk for today. If you're interested in this and other topics we've covered in our Real Talk segment, please check out our blog site at theeastsiderealestateteam.com/blog. And if you'd like to talk to us directly, you can give us a call at 425-200-4093. Thanks for listening. Up next, we'll be speaking with our lender for our Mortgage Moment segment. Mortgage Moment segment. Say that again three times fast. Stay tuned. After the commercial break, you'll hear more about the market from Michael Burdick, an experienced loan consultant with Loan Depot.